Today, we're going to talk about Greece and some of the stuff that happened. Ancient Greece was pretty important. There was a lot of stuff. There was religion, war, food, war, and culture. Culture. So, I'm going to skip forward a few years. In Greece, there was this little town called Athens. Athens was pretty cool. They had, like, a lot of stuff. They had a schooling system. They had, like, a little water fountain park thingy in the middle of their town. They had an agora, which is just, like, a little shop market. Yeah, they had a lot of stuff. But they weren't really happy with the amount of land they had. They were kind of disappointed. So, what Athens did is they went over to Persia. And they said, "Hey, Persia, I want some more land. Can you help me out?" And Persia, being the largest empire in the whole entire world, said no. And Athens threw a little hissy fit because they didn't get more land. So, basically, Athens declared war on Persia, the largest empire in the whole world. So, Athens and Persia, they were fighting a little bit. But somehow, by the name of God, Athens won. They defeated Persia. I'm going to tell you how. So, the Athens waited till about 4 in the morning. Then they snuck up to Persia's little hideout. And then they just started screaming and charging at him. And they had spears, they had shields and their armor, they were just charging at them, and all of them, they had just woken up at 4 in the morning, they had no idea what was going on, they were all in a daze. So, either, the Persians, they could wake up, put their armor on, and watch their friends die, or they could wake up and start charging back at the Athens, but get killed very easily. So, it was kind of a lose-lose. Either put on your armor, watch your friends die, or just die, you know? That's how Athens won the first Persian War. Persian War number 2. So, basically, Persia got mad because they lost. So, guess what Persia did? They declared war on Greece. So, Greece and Persia, they were at war. Again, and so basically Athens won again, but and I'm going to tell you how again. So the Athens got on their boats, and the Serbians, they got on their big boats because, you know, the bigger the better. The Athens, they were just riding around hitting Serbian ships. Serbian ships were hitting them back, but the Athens, they got them stuck in between rocks in the sea, and the Athens ships, because they were smaller, that meant they could move faster and turn around quicker. Now, see, the Serbian ships could not do that. So, basically, that's how Athens won. Again. Now I'm going to skip forward another little bit. Now, this wasn't in Greece, but it was pretty close to Greece, so I'm just going to call it Greece. So, there was this guy, he was born, his name was Alexander the Great. You may have heard of him. Alexander the Great lived up to his name. See, Alexander the Great, he was an amazing general. So, what he did is he got some people, he encouraged them to go kill other people with him. And so, that happened. He was like a good... So anyway, oh, I gotta cut that part out. So Alexander the Great, he got all his friends, conquered a lot of land, like a lot. One man and his little decent-sized army conquered a whole lot of land and killed a lot of people. And so when Alexander the Great was at this one point, he started over here, now he's over here. So Alexander the Great is over here with all his friends. And all his friends are like, "Hey, I'm tired of conquering land. I'm tired of killing people. I'm going home." But see, it would take them around 4 or 5 years to get back to home. Remember, because they started here. Now they're over here. They'd have to go... back there. Which sucks. So, you're probably wondering, why did I just tell you all this? Because all this Greek stuff affects today's society. See, if there wasn't an Alexander the Great, we'd be stuck with like a Timothy the Great or a Jude Kokonowski the Not-So-Great, you know? And that would kind of suck. So, I'm glad Alexander kind of stuck around.